Isekai is that one genre that we all gang up on to spread more and more hatred on. But despite all of that, we end up watching the first episode of it anyways. We all love to get our weird fetishes fondled deeply by Drakkun when he hits the protagonist with all of his might and bashes the character onto the next world. Well, this is a generic trope that gets us all high and keeps us engaged into watching garbage that is clearly a cash grab. Hello everyone, my name is Aram and today we will discuss in depth detail whether what has become of Isekai anime. But before all of that, just for all the normies, let's discuss briefly whether what Isekai anime actually is. It's pretty basic. The main character or characters are transported from this dimension to another dimension and spend the rest of the story in that dimension. But how they got in that another dimension? It could be that they or someone else accidentally or purposely sent them to another dimension, died and got reincarnated in another dimension, a portal opens up to another dimension, someone from another dimension summoned the main characters. Or we just don't know why or how they got in that another dimension. This is what Isekai was supposed to be, but that's apparently not what's happening. To be honest, I love the idea of an Isekai. The idea of someone getting transported to a different world has always been interesting to me. It provided to me the hope that there is a means of escapism somewhere out there in another world. I loved watching old Isekai like Inuyasha and the fact that it did everything so effortlessly and ahead of its time. They could have been influenced from the show like Alice in Wonderland or Chronicles of Narnia that came in even before them. Now I feel that Isekai has lost all of its originality and just rebranded itself as a rip-off of a fantasy genre. I call myself to be foolish to think that the genre would be evolved for the better as it gains more exposure and studios begin appealing to the newer audience. I never would have thought that the future of Isekai would become so pathetic. There are always at least few Isekai released almost every season. There are dozens of Isekai anime, but they are all absolute garbage. And I'm not hating on it, just for the sake of it. I truly am a fan of that genre and because of that, I feel like anyone new entering into this genre should see it as a trash pile it has become. Isekai has become a trash can for the shit studios to dump shit anime into. Almost every single Isekai follows a shittily made black hair justice loving overpowered main character as he builds up his harem of girls that love him for no reason other than he is nice.
Oh, what's this Ikemen?
The main character always look exactly the same with no defined features whatsoever. So that the viewer can self-insert into the character and this isn't the type of generic content all genres get. By making the main character seem ever so relatable, the artists indirectly make as well as mar the genre. There are so many Isekai night novels which got a boom after the start of Sword Art Online, thus making the Isekai era still go on 7 years later. I get it, these light novels have proven themselves to be money-making machines and studio would rather not take risk or gamble by making shows based on new concept. They print money by the bundles and make disgustingly sweat huge ass puddles. Whenever people think of Isekai, they don't think of good anime. They think all of the clone Isekai which leads to people not wanting to get into the genre despite all of the really good anime hidden under the rubble. Yes, I feel that Isekai actually amasses the highest potential of creativity than what we get. There are so many things that can be done with somebody being transported into a parallel world. You can see shows like Konosuba miming the genericness of a typical Isekai show. The chemistry between the characters and the characters and how much it makes fun of everything makes it very worthwhile to watch. Then we have Shield Hero doing everything yet so typical but still keeping us engaged into the show that we emotionally connect with the characters. Unlike most of other Isekai, Shield Hero doesn't even put the main character onto the pedestal right off the get-go. It shows us whether how it feels to have an entire country to be after you and yet prevail to live another day. With all but your own might and your own efforts. Then there is ReZero, which feels like a masterpiece within itself, with every plot point being discussed and thought over in advance. Everything linking into a bigger screen that gradually revealed to us. This is one of the magical shows that gets me riled up over people generalizing the genre as a whole and calling it trash. The recent success of Mushoku Tensei also despite the same. I mean, it's definitely a no-brainer if an anime has Sugita in it, it will be good. It features a protagonist who is basically a 36-year-old weeb who gets reincarnated in a new world. He definitely gets the idea of isekai and that he has been provided with a second chance, so as to change off his life for his better while also making a good things to come into fruition for others as well. It makes us engaged by not focusing on creating mindless harems, but by building the world and expanding it. It truly is a very good show that I recommend everyone to watch it. Well, now let's come back to the sad reality of what is happening right now. The current trend with isekai is disgusting cash grab after discussing crash grab. And it's horrible that less people are talking about it, because it needs to stop. Every shit isekai getting made is watchable anime not getting made. The more awful isekai are made, the less new people get into the genre. Soon enough, this company will realize that nobody watching their isekai anymore. And they will stop creating new isekai altogether and move on to the next trend, which in turn will be another great loss for the anime community as a whole. So these were my thoughts on what the isekai genre has turned into. I might have gone across lots of tangents across this video, but I guess it was necessary to calm down my pent up anger. With all being said and done, I would like for all of you to discover the better part of isekai genre and give you some good recommendations. Devil is a Part-Timer, ReZero, Rising of the Shield Hero, Inuyasha, Digimon, and Mushoku Tensei. That was it for this video, guys. See you in another video. Bye bye.
Hold up. Wait a minute.
By the way, guys, thank you so much for 500 subscribers. Fucking 500 subscribers.
By the way, last wala part head karna zaruri tha kya? Mummy chillai mere pe.
Anyways, guys, forget it. So the winner of our 500 subscriber special giveaway is Shreyas Joshi. Congratulations, boy, for winning this amazing manga.
Go flex, boy.
And whoever participated in this giveaway, thank you guys so much for participating and subscribing and showing support to our channel. See you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.